My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it, 6'2" in a compact, no slack, but luckily the seat.
Hello everyone, my name's Dean, let's talk crypto. This is where you subscribe for daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the price of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is December 22nd, 2022. And buckle up because the pump, the move to the upside is coming, right? It's coming. It's right around the corner. Some may even say it's here. If that interests you, then watch until the very end. We're going to talk about Bitcoin. We're going to talk about, our watch list of altcoins. We're also going to be talking about the SPX, right? The S&P 500, as well as the DXY, as always. That's our main indicator. Let's get right into it. I'm on the 4-hourly time frame, and I'm looking and seeing that thus far, our trading strategy or thesis of Bitcoin putting in this consolidation reversal pattern, breaking out correctively here, coming back to retest this triangle, this descending triangle, as resistance turned into support, and doing a consolidation reversal here for a breakout, that still holds. That has not changed. That's been our high time frame analysis. When I say high time frame, I mean for the past month, okay? Looking at what's happened since November 8th to 10th, right? The drawdown, the FTX drawdown, up until present day. So that looks good, okay? Zooming in to what we're having here, okay? This is looking good as well, right? In both cases, you'll see that the 4-hourly momentum indicator, the stochastic RSI, is completely bottomed out, all right? So we've basically moved down a bit in price, but completely down in momentum. That's a great sign. If your stochastic RSI momentum indicator can reset with just a little bit of a move in price, okay? That gives us a lot of runway to the upside. That is a good sign for upwards momentum, okay? Now, going into the hourly time frame and focusing in on this piece right here, you can see our thesis, our small time frame thesis, right? We're on the hourly time frame, is that this is a bullish pattern. It is an inverse head and shoulders, as you can see. And these typically form with a left, a head, and a right shoulder. And once this right shoulder is formed and goes back up to the neckline and breaks the neckline, the pattern is confirmed. Retests and then breakout. This is what we're expecting, okay? So this is not confirmed yet because we haven't broken the neckline to the upside, but it is looking very positive, okay? It's looking very positive. And again, on the hourly time frame, what you can see is a cross, right? Just this hour, excuse me, a cross of the K and D lines on the momentum indicator that indicates we're moving to the upside. Okay, so that's Bitcoin in a nutshell. Yesterday's episode was, I'm on a breakout watch, I think it was breakout watch. And here is the breakout, right? Here was the retest, kind of the resetting of the momentum. Retest of this important area right here that we have designated by the blue rectangle. And here's your subsequent kind of bounce breakout on the small time frame of this retest right here. Okay, so this looks good. And, you know, if you just look at this as being a zigzag, so 5-wave sequence, corrective sequence, and then a counter, this is a B wave, right? The retracement of this B wave comes to a minimum 0.5 Fibonacci retracement of this. This is exactly what we're looking for, okay? Yesterday we said, oh, maybe it's an impulse, but it can't be an impulse. It's unlikely to be an impulse just because of the time issue, right? It's taken way too long for this to form if this were a wave two, right? Because wave one and wave two are typically comparable in time and in price. So this is more likely than not an A wave and a subsequent B wave that comes to between the 0.5 and the 618 of that A wave. And then you are looking for a breakout in a C wave or impulsive move out of that corrective zigzag. So that's Bitcoin. Okay, let's quickly look at the DXY, because obviously the DXY is very important. It's our main indicator for what's going on in the crypto markets. Let's zoom out just really quickly for a bit of context. As you all know, or most of you know, the DXY has been for quite some time in a bearish pattern, okay? It's been in this head and shoulders pattern for months now, all right? Ever since July. And it's now broken down below the neckline. As you can see, this is the neckline. It's broken down below the neckline of this head and shoulders pattern. So it's confirmed bearish, okay? That's why we're very bullish in Bitcoin, stocks, cryptos, all that stuff, okay? Now, if we can now focus on this piece, we want to see the next impulsive breakdown, because this looks like a bunch of consolidation right at the neckline. Okay, so let's go into smaller time frames and really focus in on what's going on this, in this area right below the neckline. And as you can see, I've drawn another head and shoulders pattern because this is another bearish construction. As you can see, the left head and right shoulder are very clear, okay, clearly demarcated. Another thing that I spy is this. Watch this. Whatever this is, I'm not exactly sure, but it looks to be a three-wave move here, a three-wave move there, a three-wave move. Let's see. I had this figured out a second ago. It's hard to see on this time frame. I had it sorted out in my mind. And here's what I saw. This is going into detail, but I saw this as being one contiguous pattern. Okay, so that is basically a complex correction, complex flat correction that is all one. So it's basically boom, boom, boom. But in the middle, you see another flat correction. So it's a flat correction within a flat correction. Okay. But I do think it's all one contiguous structure. And I have this going something like this, like that. Nah, that doesn't really make sense because this has to end it, right? In any case, this looks to me, whatever the count is, whatever it is, if it's a triple three or double three, whatever, it just looks like a complex correction that's been going up and down with that as a resistance, right? The top being resistance, and it looks like it's put in its final wave. Why do we know that, or why do we think that? It's because the final wave of any corrective structure is always impulsive, and that, my friends, is impulsive. Just went up, hit the top of this resistance, right, which is basically the top of this right shoulder for this head and shoulders. So if we zoom back out, right, we see that this head and shoulders pattern is done. And so all it needs to do is to come back, break, retest, and then break down. Okay. So that's what we're looking for. If we use our indicators, we see that the DXY stochastic RSI on the hourly time frame is completely oversold, right? Or sorry, overbought. It's all the way topped out on the hourly time frame. It's up down on the 4-hourly time frame. Okay. And I believe on the daily as well. Yeah, it's topped out on the daily. So those are main time frames to look at momentum. And all three, the daily, the 4-hourly, and the hourly, are topped out. So this is a really good sign for a move to the downside in the DXY on the small time frames and on the large time frames, which should result in a big move in stocks, cryptos, all risk on assets. So I'm very excited about that. Okay. And speaking of stocks, we don't look at stocks much on this channel, but just to drive the point home, this is a great, great entry point, not financial advice. As we said the other day, this looks like some sort of leading diagonal where you have 1, 2, 3, 4, you have a pivot right here, and this looks like it's going up, okay? It just looks like it's going up. You see your momentum, stochastic RSI on the 4-hourly, completely oversold. The hourly is also oversold or getting into oversold territory. It just looks like a great bounce for the SPX. I'm not sure what individual stocks are going to do, but generally speaking, this index of funds looks poised to rally to the upside, okay? And, you know, the DXY is poised to break down. So that is a great sign, okay? Back to cryptos, because we know that's what we mainly care about. You can see the same thing throughout the crypto market. We're just going to go in Dodo really quickly. And you can see another inverse head and shoulders, just like I showed yesterday. This is clearly, I believe, a right shoulder. So you should get some sort of breakout here, retest, and then breakout. Okay? Your momentum indicators are showing as much on the hourly time frame. Ethereum, a little different, but I think this is a zigzag. Okay? Excuse me. This took way too long to be any kind of impulsive retracement or like intra-wave retracement, like a wave 4 or wave 2. But I think this is clearly a 5-wave, 3-wave, 5-wave type move. So it's a zigzag, okay? It fits the bill. And as I said back when this formed, it's very likely that we come back and retest that broken resistance, right? Because what did you do here? Basically broke resistance, this resistance, you came, retested it, breakout. That's all. Okay. So this is looking really good, my friends, across the board. And again, you'll see Ethereum was also all the way oversold on the stochastic RSI. Dogecoin also coming into oversold territories. You're seeing again that same concept of resistance. Resistance, broken, retested, breakout, okay? That's the basic idea. Your stochastic RSI is all the way down. So it's a good sign for continuation. Litecoin all the way in oversold territory here. Again, you see this looking like a sort of inverse head and shoulders, okay? With a left shoulder, a head, and a right shoulder. You come back to support, forming the right shoulder, and you're looking for a breakout, okay? Just looking like breakout season here, my friends. Algorand, not the strongest asset in the bunch, but it's still doing what we think it should be doing, forming a series of AB bases, right? Corrective move, counter-corrective move. Corrective move, counter-corrective move. Pivot. Breakout. That's what we're looking for. That's our count, okay? And it's really nice that our hourly stochastic RSI is completely oversold, okay? It's coming back into oversold territory, showing us that we have runway to the top. XRP. Again, I'm seeing a shade of a type of inverse head and shoulders, okay? It's not the cleanest inverse head and shoulders, but I am seeing something like that. Okay, we can see this throughout the market. Again, we can see how the stochastic RSI momentum indicator has come down into oversold territories, and we're showing to be bouncing or finding some support from these levels. Really good sign for continuation into a big breakout. RSR, what do you see here? More of the same, okay? Left head, right shoulder, inverse head and shoulders, bullish construction, completely oversold on this Castigar side. Guys, sounds like a broken record, but the market's not always doing exactly the same thing, but similar things, okay? And this is what we're spying in the markets here. Cardano, not the strongest, but kind of like what you see in Algorand. You see a series of AB bases, okay? Break, counter. Break, counter. That's 2 degrees of AB basing. Pivot. Breakout. Completely oversold on the stochastic RSI, right? That 25 cent zone is a great area for support. Excuse me. And last but not least, just added this on spot. Talcoin looking really, really good, okay? And this is looking particularly good on the really high time frames. As you can see, this is clearly some sort of impulsive move, right? And this is clearly a corrective move. And I believe that this is a zigzag. And this, all of this was the bear market accumulation, right? Right here. From May until present day. And so it's already starting to come out of that bear market accumulation. So any buy here is great buy, but I just got into this last night. It's looking poised to break out on a high, high time frame from this big move, big counter move, right? It's going back into a big move. I like the project. I like this chart on the high time frames, on the small time frames. So I just invested a very small amount. But if the bull market does play out, that small amount should turn into a very big amount. Guys, that's all I have for you today. Hope you're doing well. It's rainy here in the DC metro area, but we're happy. We're really happy. We're optimistic. We're positive. It's likely that we're going to get a big move in the markets very, very soon, much sooner than later. All right, that's all I have for you today. Take care, and I'll see you tomorrow.
The police, because they can't arrest me.
My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet 2 in a compact.